What's going on, guys? It is Carly here bringing you another weekly dose of horror, and today we are moving along with the Conjuring franchise, and next up we have Annabelle. This is the film that came right after The Conjuring, a year after to be exact. This came out in 2014. I think I said in my last video that The Conjuring came out in like 2010 or something like that, but that movie came out in 2013, and then they did a spinoff on a doll that is mentioned in that film, and that is, of course, the Annabelle doll. So, yeah, this movie essentially follows this couple by the names of John and Mia, and they're expecting a child as well, but, you know, they live at home. I think John, he is in school to be a doctor, or he is a doctor, and he's just going for further schooling or something like that, but, and then Mia just stays at home, and of course she's about to have a baby, so she's, sort of a stay-at-home, soon-to-be mom, and, John decides to buy her this gift, just, for the heck of it, and it is this vintage doll. The reason being is because you see that Mia collects vintage dolls. You see that early on, that she has a room full of dolls, and that's just kind of her thing. So he finds this Annabelle doll. She's super happy with it. It doesn't, you know, it doesn't look all terrifying or anything like that yet, because it's just a basic vintage doll. So she's pleased with it. And then things kind of take a turn for the worse when their neighbors are attacked by these devil worshippers who are part of this cult. They attack the neighbors, and then they come over and attack John and Mia, and they basically end up infecting the doll with this evil presence, and stuff starts to sort of escalate from there, and they have to try to figure out what the heck they're going to do with this. So, yeah, Annabelle, this is a movie I saw in the theater when it came out and didn't really care for it too much. Saw it with my mom and my aunt, and I remember they both also thought it was pretty stupid. You know, I didn't think it was horrible, but I didn't think it was that good. Rewatched it a few years ago and thought it was total trash, because I had heard multiple people say, oh, that's like the worst movie ever, and in my head I was like, I don't think it was that bad, and then rewatching it I was like, oh yeah, it is actually that bad. Watching again this time, it's not as bad as I thought on that last watch. I feel like the build-up with just kind of John and Mia and the character developments. Of course, they do end up having their daughter, which is, they name her Leah. So you get like good character development with them and the family, and just seeing the, you know, struggles where after that cult kind of attacks them, Mia doesn't want to live in the house anymore, so they move into this apartment, and so there's a good amount of build up and some tension with that, and you get some decent scenes with the doll as well, where it's just like in a rocking chair and the chair is rocking by itself. So there are some creepy moments, I will say. I think the movie kind of takes a turn for the worse when stuff actually starts to go down and the actual scary parts begin to happen, because they're just super fake, generic, ghostly stuff, bad CG, just kind of cringeworthy lines and stuff like that start to happen throughout the film, and just super fake. That's a big problem with the film, is it just becomes a very generic haunted doll movie, and that's it. There's not a whole lot to it. Just a lot of ridiculous stuff starts to kind of go down, and you just kind of don't really care anymore about these characters, because it just becomes super unrealistic, where in The Conjuring, you know, there's a few unrealistic parts of that as well, but it's done a lot better. It's got way better atmosphere, way better characters, and just acting in general, and the jump scares and scary moments are actually effective, where in this movie, they're just those very generic jump scares that don't even really get you, because you kind of either see them coming, or they're just not super frightening, because like I said, there's some not so good effects with people's faces and stuff like that in this movie that might have worked for me when I was like, I don't know, 11 or something like that. But as an adult watching this movie, it's just a little bit cringeworthy. So yeah, Annabelle, not a good movie, not as bad as I kind of thought last time, but definitely super step down, especially if you think like this is the one that came after The Conjuring, and it's supposed to be in the same universe. They really kind of dropped the ball with it. So, Annabelle, I give this, I give it a 5 out of 10. I've seen definitely worse, way worse than this film. So I would say it's just right there on average. There's nothing too special about it. So 5 out of 10 for Annabelle. Thank you guys once again for joining me for this Weekly Dose of Horror, and as always, I'll see you next week.